Ara-ra-ra-ra, oh-ro-ro-ro-ro, yeah. As you can see,
oh, yes.
We are all very young.
Very, very young.
Say, ha, okay.
Following the many controversies surrounding Wizkid's exit and comeback to EME, the youngster has delighted fans with a brand new single featuring Ace Afrobeat legend Femi Kuti, titled Jari Jari. The Starboy has worked with some of the biggest names locally and internationally, including Akon, The Game, Cardinal Official, Wale, Young Jeezy, M.I., Iyanya, Ice Prince, amongst others, but this just seems to be getting the most media buzz. Fans took to Twitter to express their joy and love for the song, and as speculated by many Afrobeats lovers, Wizkid might be becoming the new phase of Afrobeats in Nigeria. Produced by pop beatmaker Saz and mixed and mastered by the astute and timeless mixmaster and sound engineer Foster Zeno, Wizzy gives his best on vocals while Kuti spreads his famous saxophone tunes all over. However, it would have been a highlight if Femi Kuti dropped his vocals.
He called my sister and asked me if I would play on it. I think he thought maybe I would be a very difficult person.
I was shocked, I was surprised, and when I called Femi, he didn't even hesitate. He says, I have no problem.
Fortunately, I'm traveling tomorrow, so I couldn't find how to fix my time because I'm on Nigerian Idol and today was the closing day. So I said he should wait till he can wait till I come back. And he said, no, he wants to release it on the 1st of May, that it's urgent. And that became very stressful. So I think my sister wanted me to do it yesterday, but yesterday I played on Thursday, I was too tired. So it was either to do Nigerian Idol today and rush from Nigerian Idol and come here. So I said I'd be doing it.
I was shocked, I was surprised, and when I called Femi, he didn't even hesitate. He says, I have no problem. If he could fit into his schedule, because he's traveling tomorrow, and but I mean, you know, Wiz supports us all the time for collaboration, so we must support him for his own projects.
We are in the studio now with the legendary Femi Kuti. Big shout out to Auntie Yenny. She made this possible, so big shout out to her. Like, you have to show her right there. She's, can I show you one?
So Wiz supports us all the time for collaboration, so we must support him for his own projects. It's a given. So once Godwin gave me the call, I didn't even hesitate. He knows.
Shebu was just there, you called me.
Yes, ma'am.
And we are here today.
Such
so.
A very short
meeting. No, it was Thursday.
No, okay.
Because Femi was rehearsing, I remember. So we're happy to be here. And I'm sure Femi is happy to be here. Stop it, stop. Go.
Studio things, man, you know. we're doing it for TV, you know what I mean?
That's a list of those who are praying and those who are praying.
See, I fought through defeat, now I am living a better life. And I'm thankful for the life that I am.
I'm listening to it. It makes a lot of sense.
Okay.
So even the lyrics make sense. I think when somebody like Wizkid asked me, it's for me to put the best of my professionalism to enhance his creativity for decades to come. If I can put a dynamic solo part that everybody will say, wow, and say, oh, they like what we did together, then credit to him. So, I mean, at this stage of my career, it's when somebody like Wizkid comes and he wants me to, it's always put my best.
to play my song, but I heard what he's going to come up with, so I just gave it to him.
Okay.
Because he's amazing like that.
Alright, so you feel he would do better on the beat than you?
Yeah, from what I heard.
So 2 a.m. he got the beat.
2 a.m. he came to my house. 2 a.m. Big shout out to Shaz. You know, I woke him up from sleep. He didn't want to come, so I forced him. I begged him. So he came through with the beat. 2 a.m. I heard it. I didn't sleep till like 5 a.m. that day because I just put the beat on repeat and I was just listening to it. And I was like, wow, it's crazy. So that's why I'm here to be.
Okay. Most of your songs, they talk about life, women, success, and what is this one talking about, basically?
This one, prayer, everything that's been going on in my life, you understand? Like, and what I still want for myself as well, you understand? This is a very optimistic song, like, it just, you know, just praying everything goes well, plenty of prayer in this song.
The lyrics in my, if I was meditating, I can laugh about what you're saying. It sounds funny to me. A young guy dreaming that these are the things he would love to do, which is very encouraging for young people. Young people that want to help their father. I mean, so the lyrics, they don't sound stupid. So it's not something that I will say, I don't want to really be identified with this, but I'm doing. Do you understand what I'm saying? I could understand where it's coming from. So it's a very, I'm sure I'll finish this in one or two takes. It's not a difficult thing to accustom myself with.
Yes, man. No, it's not always about champagne, nice watch, gold, everything, money, and all those things. You understand? I just decided to go like a little bit deeper.
If you would do a song with a rapper in Nigeria, who would you like to do a song with?
A rapper in Nigeria? Oh, who have I not done a song with? Is that what you're saying? That's tricky.
No, we have some rappers.
I have some rappers. I've done everything with every rapper. I think I've worked with a lot of rappers. I've worked with MI, I've worked with Aish, I've worked with Jesse, I've worked with everyone. I'm working with Nito C right now. We just did something. That sounds crazy. And I just did something with the band as well. So,
would you like to do something with Mod 9, Vector?
The band is not a rapper, Shaw. I don't know.
Yeah, like,
so you heard it, man. It's so, I can't even explain it because when I did this track, you know, it was in my head from the beginning. I just wanted like Uncle Femi on the track. Like from when I did the beat, when I heard the beat, when Sass played me the beat, I was like, no, man. I just have to put him on this track, and you know. I recorded the track and now we are here, so like just stick around.
Wait.
I'm definitely gonna be at every collaboration till eternity.
My problem is always time factor. If Wizkid probably did not say he was releasing in 1st of May, I would tell him to wait till I came back. Now I don't know why, probably it's good that he insisted I come now, because maybe when I come back, I'll be too busy with another project. And you know, I've got my own things I'm doing. So it's not like I'm difficult. It's time factor. And he always honors us when we say he should come to celebration. So my sister was like, please do it for him. So they are taking me out of my comfort zone, really, because I have a very hectic tour starting from tomorrow. A lot of press and blah, 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 that I should be resting, especially after the hectic Nigerian Idols. I should really be resting at my age. But it was, no, you must do it. So at this point of, like I said, at this point in my career, I will have to sacrifice my comfort for creativity, for people like Wizkid. So I'm not difficult. It's always time factor. I mean, if you just call me, and even if I don't like the song and a young artist wants me to do something, if I agree, it's always important I put the best I can to enhance the creativity of the artist.
Good.
That's it.
Ara-ra-ra-ra. Oh-ro-ro-ro-ro. Yeah. As you can see.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, oh, very young.
Very, very young. Mufa kale fuma mami. Mufa rale fuma bami. Ayeni Miami. Maserati kui ya wobi. Ferrari Versace. Ferragamo Bugatti. Olo Butori. Mufa lo obi adenuga. Mufa fe sosa. Mufasi pepe rebe. All of them for me. Ati ti baby. For the life.